Well guys, in today's video, we are turning the 4Runner stock head unit from this into this with TrailGrid Pro's 8100 series Sony head unit, plug and play, so let's get into it. So that's right guys, it's a plug and play system, our favorite. So as you can see, I already took out the stock head unit. If you guys wanna know the full removal, I will leave that up in the iCard up above for you guys on how to properly remove your stock head unit. So before we install it, I just wanna show you guys the kit and everything that they provide. Link and discount code will be down in the description for you guys. But with this, we have the Sony 8100 screen, a very large, almost 9-inch screen to replace the old one. We also have the dash kit that matches perfectly. I mean, look at that. And then we have all the accessories that will come with it. This is a new mount, guys, from Metro, which is awesome because it retains your factory little spots right there. But this over here is exactly how it came, aside from being bubble wrapped and protected and everything by TrailGrid Pro. This is exactly how it came. So guys, plug and play, they do everything. They label all of the harnesses. You can run your backup camera, front camera, accessory cameras, anything with this. This will plug in for your stock reverse camera. They've labeled everything here too, and it is all vehicle specific. So if you have a 2010 to 13 4Runner, they have some different stuff. If you have the JBL sound system, if you want to keep your XM radio, all of those options are all selectable on their website. So they provide you, they solder, they do everything the correct system. So coming to the bottom of the system, they already put the pack down there, nice and Velcroed on, very simple, nice setup, and that will allow your 4Runner to not throw any codes when you plug it in. It will allow the 4Runner to also use the steering wheel controls as well. So everything will work as advertised when you put this in. So let's go ahead and install this thing real quick. All right, so depending on your application for what your 4Runner has, the included instructions, which are absolutely awesome, will tell you which things you guys need to plug in. So when you take the brains of the unit over here, you're not gonna utilize every single one of the factory harnesses. So for mine, it says combination 3. I will use vehicle connector 2, 4, and 5. So I'm only gonna be using 3 of them. Obviously then too, you still need to plug in your antenna and everything like that. So just make sure those ones are plugged in, but for the ones that say vehicle connector, I'm only gonna be using those 3. Here, 4. So I am noticing too, obviously I don't have the satellite radio one that I'm gonna be plugging in. And then this is for the GPS. So I don't see anything for the GPS, but hopefully the 4Runner will still say north and south when I'm driving in my information cluster right here. But other than that, it's done. Don't forget to attach your microphone as well. We'll find a spot for that. And then this just goes in and you put your 10mm bolts into it, and that's about it. And then your hazard lights too. Don't forget about those. All right, everything is plugged in. I checked everything with the screen on it first before I put it all away. But now we're going to take our cover, and then this literally should just go into place. Move that. So that just goes there. All right, and I just buttoned everything up, put the back on, USB is plugged in properly, and then also put the 2 screws on top. Super simple install. Well, guys, it's installed, and it works freaking awesome. Doesn't look too bad. Still have access up here to the vents. Hazards still work. Still have access to the climate control down here. It's about two fingers from the back, but CarPlay works really well. It's attached to the stock USB down there. So that works really, really well. Can change all your music, sounds good. Steering wheel controls work. So turn it up, turn it down. This button down here, the voice one, actually will activate Siri when you're in CarPlay. If you wanna go back home, what I really love about this just blue, it's just simple, clean, easy. And the blue matches the 4Runner blue over here. So that's what I absolutely love about these Sony units, is that it's so simple, so minimalistic. Like I said, everything works. Volume up, volume down. If you press it to the right, it's gonna go through all your presets. If you hold it up or down, It'll seek, which is very sweet. So it'll seek to find a good signal. Everything works, as of now, absolutely perfect on this. As usual, guys, I will do follow-up videos for you all. I will show you everything that's bad about it, or if it continues to be incredible, like the first impressions have been, then I will show you guys that it's good. Up here, I put the microphone. So I just came out the back of it, changed out the adapter because there was a clip one, and then I just put the double-sided sticky little film that they give you. Called my wife with it on CarPlay. She said it sounded really good. So, hey, it works. If you have Sirius XM, you're good there. Bluetooth, HDMI, it's under here for the driver. So you could put anything HDMI with it and you could technically watch it while driving. And then rear camera works as well. So that's your rear camera. And then if you put the vehicle in reverse, we have the reverse cam too. And then with these new little lines there. So it has those lines too. But if you want just the Toyota stock lines, go ahead, turn it off, put the car back in park or drive, and then you're off to go. So super snappy, works really good. The aftermarket speakers that I have in this 4Runner actually sound really good now with this new head unit able to amplify it a bit more. So that's cool. I'm actually getting more sound quality and clarity out of the speakers that I put into this 4Runner, gosh, almost 2 years ago now. So sounds really good. Incredibly easy install, guys. Trail Grid, absolutely good job. Directions were simple. Videos were simple. It was just so easy and good to do. If I wasn't filming, this probably would have taken me, I mean, I'm mechanically inclined, an hour, maybe an hour in your own garage, by, you know, taking your time, taking the old system out, transferring everything over, simple plug and play, maybe an hour, maybe. So guys, if you are new around here and you like installs like this on your Toyota vehicles, definitely make sure that you guys subscribe. Returning subscribers, as always, I appreciate your guys' support, and I will catch you in the next video. All right, see you later.